Hello, everyone. Welcome to number 18 on my Galaxy Girls list. Today is Pavo, the peacock constellation. It took me a while to have a solid concept idea for this piece. I wasn't sure if I wanted to do just a peacock design or actually include a peacock animal, but I ended up going with just the design. So first, I'm laying down the colors in the background with watercolor and adding some of that salt. I'm also doing a bit of that under lace tone in her dress like I did in the cross piece yesterday. Basically everything I do in the beginning is usually going to be covered up a bit, so I always want to start with the main colors and the main tones in the background so they are dry and ready to go when I'm ready to do detail over them. Again, I did a little mock-up with my iPad Pro and Procreate before going into this piece, so I knew exactly what color scheme I wanted to go with and the composition. That has been helping me a lot time-wise, not having to make mistakes with traditional medium and taking a lot longer to cover them up. If I was just doing Inktober as a sketching process, I probably wouldn't do that, but since this is going to be a book and prints and all of that stuff, I want to make sure I like the design and plan it out at least a little bit. I have a lot of my supplies linked below, but I have also added the iPad that I use. A lot of you have asked which one I have, so I linked that below. With the black hair in this piece and all of the pieces, I like to do a wet into wet technique where I put down water and then drip the black ink into it. As you can see now that it's dry here, it creates a bit of a textured piece instead of just straight black. I tend to edit in a more deeper black afterwards, but a bit of the texture stays in there and I like the variation. It's also been a little too fast to see, but besides just the salt, I also drop water, just clear water, into either the watercolor or the ink as it's drying, and that's what gives some of the spread out texture. After Inktober, when I can start to make more edited, longer videos, I'll definitely show some of those techniques. It really hit me today that I have done 18, essentially, paintings in this month so far, and whew, that's a lot of work. This is definitely the most amount of work I've ever put out in such a short amount of time, so big steps this Inktober for sure, big learning experiences. How are you guys handling Inktober, and definitely let me know what you've learned throughout the process. I'd love to read what your goals were with your personal Inktober, if it's helped. I don't know too many people who have done Inktober and said that it didn't improve themselves in some way or another. I'd also love to hear if any of you guys are still sticking with it. I know quite a few people on my Life Inc. 18 list who are taking part in this Galaxy Girls prompt list are still going strong and are even ahead of me, totally on time. So I'm really impressed with how many people are still doing Inktober. I will say I have noticed quite a decline in how many people are looking up Inktober or posting. I think it's usually around this time, at least this time in the month, that I give up, but I'm not giving up at all with these pieces. I am doing all 31 for sure, even if it takes me a bit into November. If you're behind at all, there's no shame in running into November a little bit. Although I'm super excited I've done 18, that still means that I have 13 more paintings to go. Oh man, it hurts a little bit to say out loud. My body is mad at me. It's like, you gotta stop doing all this, but I'm not gonna stop. It is a bit of a strange feeling when I finish these pieces, because usually when I finish a painting like this, or a larger illustration, I feel such a relief because I can kind of relax for a little bit. Like, I always give myself a bit of a break, but at the end of finishing these, there's no break. It's like, okay, you get to go sleep and wake up and start it as fast as possible so you can get some sleep tomorrow and then start it again as fast as possible. It's complete and utter madness, for sure. The whole starting a week before would have been awesome if I had been able to do it, but a bunch of things came up the week before Inktober, so I only got to do like one piece ahead of time, so I got quickly behind. It wouldn't be so bad to just finish a piece on the day of, like Inktober is supposed to be, but since I'm filming and editing and posting the video as well, it definitely would have helped to start a little bit beforehand, so I could have edited video and had it ready to go. But hey, learning experience for next time, if I can do this again next time. Random announcement, I will be at DesignerCon in November. I think it's November 16th through the 18th. It's a convention that has recently moved to Anaheim, California. So if any of you will be there, be sure to stop by. I love that show so, so much. It's one of my favorites. The crowd is just a really chill, modern crowd, really looking to support the arts and creatives instead of like comic book conventions and stuff like that, where it's more about the fame, I feel like, and of course the fan art and all that, but I feel like DesignerCon is more for original ideas and original art, so it's definitely one of my favorites. I won't have, obviously, the book or anything like that from these pieces there, just because I will be getting all of that ready with the Kickstarter, so it'll take some more time. Again, the Kickstarter hasn't been launched yet, but I'm working on it, hoping to have it launched as soon as possible. But yeah, I will have other things that are on my online shop now, including my Floral February coloring book and the last of my goddesses book. In fact, I don't think I will be printing the goddess book again. That book was done in 2016 for that Inktober, including some of my senior art school pieces. Basically, I did goddesses from across the world for that Inktober, and I didn't finish, but I got pretty far. So the last of those books are in my shop right now, along with the coloring book. Also, if you've ordered from my shop, I am a bit backlogged from doing all these, but I'm trying to get them out as soon as possible, including those of you who have ordered the digital download of the coloring book. I'll be emailing those out as soon as I can. Back to this piece. This one was another one that just was not hard for me at all. I don't know if it's because I'm planning it out so much on my iPad first, or just because the design is pretty straightforward. I was comfortable with the pose and designing all of the elements, so it's always nice when I know exactly what I want to do and can just relax and go through the process without worrying about how the composition is going to look or if I'm putting the right color in the right area. So I had a lot of fun with it. You might not be able to see from the video, but I am putting gold embellishments on her, not only in the constellation, but also in her headpiece. The area around the dark spot of the peacock feathers is gold. I said I wasn't going to use gold this year in my Inktober pieces, but I definitely failed on that because I've been using it a lot lately. And the rest is just slowly building up the design and the layers, adding stars, which is kind of annoying. Stars are a little weird. I don't like to do like the paint flick technique because I feel like, you know, if you put paint on a toothbrush or a brush and kind of like flick it, it will do a little splatter. And I know some people do that to make stars, but I don't really like to do it because some of them won't be circular. There'll be like a line, and to me, it doesn't look like the way I want to design stars. So I go in dot by dot, and it takes a while, and it's kind of weird trying to randomize the stars while looking realistic. I water down my white paint a little bit while doing some of them, so some seem farther away, whereas the pure white ones look kind of brighter and close up. If I wanted to get really detailed, I would go in and make some colored stars, but I just haven't been doing that. By the time I'm doing the stars in the piece, I kind of just want it to be over, so if I do end up doing color, maybe I'll edit it later on. Thank you. Okay, and here is the finished piece. Hopefully you can see a bit of the detail closer up. I hope you enjoyed her. Be sure to subscribe if you'd like to follow along in this series, and I will see you tomorrow for number 19, Scorpio. Have a lovely day!